Hello, it is I, Jay. And today it's a first for the channel. We're gonna be fixing some OMGs in like full depth. Now I haven't done much OMG content on my channel because I didn't think anyone really liked it, just judging by, you know, performance and all that stuff. But I did ask you guys on my community tab if you would like to see an OMG cleaning up video and which one of the two characters you would like to see. But surprise, I did both of them because, you know, me. Polls don't mean nothing. Just kidding. But today we're going to be looking at Dolly and Downtown BB. Unfortunate name for her. But these two dollies were thrifted from La Saviere's and they've just been needing a makeover, especially Downtown. I'm not saying BB. Downtown is her name, okay? But yeah, guys, let's jump right into this video. Roll the intro. So here are victims for today's video. We have Dolly DeVille and Ashnikko with a tan. Downtown has the worst hair, it is super matted, and some of her body parts do not match others. So of course, both girlies are going to be getting their hair washed, but I will be removing one of their bangs. Can you guess who? So because I already own a Winter Disco Dolly, I really wanted to remove her bangs to see what she would look like, you know, without them. So I'm just going to get some tweezers and just start yanking at the roots. We're going to really pull back her original hair so we only yank out the bangs. Surprisingly, these bangs are really in there and I've yanked out bangs before, but Dolly's were just really on lock and they were really, you know, a pain to get out. But once I got the white side off, I was looking at the black bang like, oh, this is kind of a cute little one side bang, but I was going to go through with my plan and just yank those out as well. But look at this serve without the bangs. Like, okay, come through, Miss Dolly. You actually are serving right now. But now that we've gotten her bangs out, we can prep her hair and get her ready to be washed. I wanted to pluck out Downtown's bangs as well, but the way MGA rooted them was a no-go, so she's just gonna have to be, you know, messy. But now, guys, it is time to get our dolls ready to be washed and all that stuff. Before I get her hair wet, I split her hairline down the middle like Moses did with the Red Sea. And now I'm just wetting her hair so that the dish soap sticks to it. Speaking of dish soap, this is the one I use. I'm just adding a good amount to her hair because she was thrifted. And then I just massage it in. I kind of got worried because it is orange and she has white hair, but it didn't stain, thank God. And because we used a lot of dish soap in her hair, we can use that for her face and her body. I'm also going to be using a toothbrush to really clean inside her grooves and all that stuff. And once I feel like I'm satisfied with her sudsiness, I'm just rinsing her out with some warm water. This part is always so fun to me for some reason. I don't know why, but I think it's because all the suds like disappear and, you know, I'm just a child at heart, okay? But now that Dolly is all clean, I'm going to be setting her aside so now we can clean Miss Downtown, the mess herself. Now, with Downtown, I haven't had a lot of hope with her. I really went into this makeover just knowing I'm probably going to have to reroot her. And sometimes it's just be like that, guys. Can't save everything. Doll, but you can try. Now the weird thing about this doll's hair is it feels like it has had heat damage, and like when I say that, it feels like someone might have crimped her hair originally because it felt like it was not just matted, because I've dealt with matted hair before in like my Violet Willow restoration video or my Maya Rain restoration video. Now this chick was just something else, okay guys? After I washed her hair and her body, I just did warm water once again to get all the soap out, and I did use a lot on her and it did, you know, suds up my sink, which was annoying, but we got it out, okay? Now that the girlies are all washed and cleaned, it is time to add moisture to their hair, and this is my favorite part. If you've watched my restoration videos before, I use this Suave conditioner. It's something special. It just cost me $2 and it's lasted me all year, so I mean, it's worth it if you're going to be washing a lot of dolls. I just added a good amount to the doll's hair, and Dolly didn't really have bad hair in general. I just always use conditioner either way so it's easier to brush out. Just going in with my conditioner brush. It's like a knockoff wet brush, but I really do need to get a wire brush because that just works so much better with doll hair, and I used to use one, but now I need to get a new one. But I'm just brushing at the ends and working my way up because she did have a little bit of knots from me washing her hair. So look at the wonders conditioner does for doll hair. Now moving on to Downtown, because her hair is so matted, we're going to be doing this in sections. Downtown originally had two ponytails, but her part is long gone because it's been brushed out to filth. So I am just going to be trying to make my own part right here and start splitting off her hair. Now, no matter how much brushing I did, it felt like there was just nonstop knots and it would just tangle up no matter what I did. So here's just a clip of me brushing one side because it was really annoying to wash her hair, guys, okay? And I was really happy when it was over, so yay. And just like Dolly, I put her hair under some warm water. We're not using hot water yet. Now it was Dolly's turn to get all of her conditioner out, and her hair honestly was just the best out of these two, and thank God. So since Dolly is perfect pretty much, I just need to style her hair. We are going to move her aside and work on downtown because her hair is still really bad. Doll burrito time it is for you, Dolly. Sashay away. So I decided to boil some water for Miss Downtown, and we are going to give her a good old boil wash. I first started by dunking her bangs in because I thought, oh, this will just help them stay down, but they decided to defy gravity, so I had to brush them down with my toothbrush, and then I just started dunking the rest of her hair in the boiling water. I did actually let it set in there for a good minute I think it was a minute. After a minute, I just started dunking it back and forth, and then we moved on to brushing it out. And honestly, guys, it still felt bad. It was a little better, but it still felt really burnt from like a heat tool of some sort. It seemed that my only resort now was going to be straightening it. And yeah, this was it after the straightening, and I don't know, it still felt really bad. So I decided to put her hair in a ponytail, and now I was going to crimp it because if I can't get the weird texture out, I'm just going to add more texture in it. So if you're unaware of how to use a crimper on doll hair, I actually have a full video on how I did it. Basically, you're gonna need the doll's hair to be very, very wet. And you're gonna need some kind of heat protectant or curl cream. I usually go with curl cream because I just have it. I start by wetting her hair. I could have just used the sink, but I don't know. I wasn't thinking right here. You're also gonna wanna make sure that there's no tangles or knots in it. I mean, she already had some, but I'm just trying my best here, guys, okay? And it was at this point she looked like one of those trolls dolls from the 2000s. If you remember those, let me know in the comments. But now I'm just gonna be adding my curl cream. I use a good amount for the entire hair section that I'm gonna be working on. I give it one last brush, and I make sure that my crimper is on the lowest setting. If you get comfortable, you could go higher, but I recommend using a low setting all the time. We hold the crimper on each section for 3 to 4 seconds. If you hear a sizzling, it's just the water evaporating. And if you leave it on for longer, you might cinch the doll's hair off. So you've been warned. I am not responsible for your crimping. And this is what your first section looks like. It's kind of cute, not gonna lie. But I did realize that this doll's hair was not taking the crimps very well, and it looked very straight still. So you know what? I'm done with her. She's just gonna look like this, and she's getting a reroute. I don't care. Goodbye. And here is Dolly. She's obviously the only one who really got a makeover out of this. I'll show you downtown right after. But I just put her in this girl's outfit. She came with two outfits. Both of her outfits are really bad quality. That's just my opinion. But I gave her her top and her bottom, and then I just gave her Lyric's little first coat and her first pair of shoes. I keep it on brand with Dolly because obviously she's supposed to be like Cruella DeVille, and she had some pink accents to her as well. So I feel like this is a really good little look for her, and I'm really happy with her. I really love how her hair turned out. I had it in a hairnet right after, and I just pulled it up to give it like that Frankenstein kind of motif, and I love this so much. As for downtown, I'm really like just disappointed with her hair. It could have been so much better. And honestly, as I said, you can't save every doll. Sometimes the conditions are just not manageable, and she's just one of those dolls. And she does kind of look cute if you, you know, kind of squint and look very far back. But I don't know, guys, it's just her bangs, and you know, there's so much flyaways, and it's just, not even the crimps could help it. And it didn't even keep the crimps. So yeah, guys, if I do plan on rerouting her, what should I do? I might actually get her commissioned because I really don't want to reroute an OMG doll. But yeah, guys, that is the end of our first ever OMG restyling video that's like in full depth and not a short. Tell me what you guys think of both of them. Do you think Downtown is still cute the way she is, or should I just reroute her? Because you know me, I love chopping doll hair off when it misbehaves. And also, do you like how Dolly turned out? Because obviously she got the full makeover experience. Anyways, guys, if you are new to my channel, hi, my name is Jay and I do doll stuff, duh. And if you aren't following me on Instagram or TikTok, my username is also Zombiexcorn there. I post lots of doll content as well. I would love you guys to join the family. We are almost at 300K. I can't believe that. Like, what? Wow, what a year. Thank you guys so much. And guys, my room is currently a mess, but I mean, it always is. Oh yeah, by the way, I brushed out Amaya's hair because I was not happy with it, and I'm gonna redo it one day. Yeah, guys, I'm actually going to be having my own room for once. I've shared with one of my siblings for a long time, pretty much, and I'm finally gonna have like a whole little doll room, so I don't have to worry about this little desk anymore and squatting and all that stuff. So probably in the beginning of next year, you'll see me setting up my doll room, kind of like X Kind of Dances has been doing, and you know, I'm gonna do a video just like that. Girl, if you're watching, hey girl, hey, love you. You guys should totally subscribe to her because she's like an icon. But yeah, guys, I'm excited for you guys to see that journey with me. I'm so excited to have all my dolls back up because this is just like half of my collection. Obviously, this is all my Rainbow High dolls, but like this is just half of the Monster High collection. And also, my OMGs aren't even on display. I only have these three and then the two others, I guess you can say. Yeah, guys, that's just the little updates for now. I will see you guys in my next video, and I hope you guys had a good Thanksgiving. Okay, guys, I will see you in the next one. Bye for now.